throttle.
This is how we do it every morning.
That's how we do it every morning. Promising soldier.
I heard that.
Promising athlete.
I just faced the other way. This is our high school. Try to get those hips.
Those hips. What you running with? Hips. What you running with?
Okay. That's good. Fired up. Fired up. Take your time. Take your time, warm up. Ain't no rush. Ain't no rush to warm up. Don't rush your body through. Let's go. If your body got to do what it's ready to do, and if you're forced to do it, you're stretching it, tearing down the muscle too, and you make it forcing it to do what it's not ready to do. Kind of like you ain't ready to wake up, you ain't ready to wake up. I'm trying to force you to get up, but you're like, I ain't not ready. I'm up, but I'm not functional. I'm no good to nobody. I'm just in motion, so. Take your time, let your body. You'll feel it. Don't force it. Just let it just. Okay, go a little bit higher. A little bit higher. It's not you'll make that muscle weak. You make your hamstring weak. That's why a lot of guys pop hamstrings. They're force stretch so much that all that weight room workout, the muscle got the attachment, the hamstring attachment, weak and they pop. Like I've been working my hamstring. Yeah, but you don't even do a warm-up lap, you don't do the warm-up drill, you just get, lay down, push my leg, push them up. And I see that and I cringe, I'm like, oh my goodness, they making that muscle do more than it's ready to do. It ain't woke up, it ain't had its coffee.
That sounds like it's a practice.
Yeah.
You're just trying to do it.
Trying to hurry up and get it in. And that's why they end up hurt. Iced up, bandaged up, on the sideline. When we warm it up, if I'm not with you warming up, take your time. If you got time, this is where you do all this. So when you get to these clinic combine and stuff, and they got y'all doing all kind of crazy drills, and you don't have time to do what your body used to, you've already got it in. You got it in the day before, the morning before, or before you went to the facility. Like my body already got what it needed. This is going to be extra. For me, when everybody's just like, ooh, oh, stretch, oh, I can't. And you'd be like, oh, okay, I'm ready. I'm ready to go. I'm gonna loosen my baby up. I'm ready to roll. Yeah, so don't ever force it. That's why we teach, Dad was telling you about staying on your stretching, staying on your mobility, standing, keeping those hips loose, no matter where you are. Well, yeah, I keep telling my trail all the time. I've seen a billion times doing the ATF through the parking lot of Walmart. Yeah, just track drill. We're going in the store. He just keeping his body in rhythm all the time. And then when you get on that track, you see him like, that's the same thing he was doing in the Walmart parking lot.
Wow.
he looked the same going in the store he did running against Bo, Tyson Gay, and all that. But that's why he could always be like this. I even wondered, like, how in the world, Trill, when you see him, all you see is a milk, I call it a milk good head, and you see two knees. I'm like, how's he doing it? But he practices it on, off the track. Look, some of the stuff looks like as silly as I don't know. It's like, why is he? Man, come on here and walk. Oh. Gotta be ready. Gotta be ready. Gotta fire the engine up. So, yeah. I'm gonna do some, five times. You ready to roll. You don't need too much. The body should be good. Whoa. Lean. Whoa. There you go. In the position, striking down. Just letting it know. Hey, we're gonna strike. We're gonna come up. Press. Good. We're not gonna press and stress. We're gonna strike. Firing that engine, firing the bits up. It ain't woke. Oh, you're gonna run a hot time today. You're gonna run a hot time today. You said you felt it. Well, I wanna know when I got in the truck. Do I need to go ahead and go back in the house? y'all let me know. Let me know what high went down. You fired up. Oh boy. When athletes feel it. What you love to hear. Sorry. You don't force it. You're just going through the drill. Just go. You got to go so hard. Just letting that hip know. This is the way I'm running. Running here. I'm not going to probably be here when the active time comes. I'm going to be probably here. I might even be here. But even here, I'm cycling. That's just a quicker. That's just lower. That's all that. All this is called anywhere from here to right here. It's called lower heel recovery. Just high. That's all they call it. This is real high heel recovery because it takes a long time to get my heel to recover here. This is low heel recovery. And what you're doing is no heel recovery. That's a new one. I'm about to post that. Yeah, anybody got no heel recovery? You got low, high, low, or no? And your athlete has no heel recovery. Well, this is perfect. Perfect warm up. Well, you made me feel like I'm looking for TK now. I'm looking for the blocks to come out. That's what I feel like. But you got to put your body in sprinter mode.
Sprinter mode.
It's got to be sprinter mode. You can't run like no baseball player. You can't run like no football player. You got to run like a sprinter.
You hear that? You got to think like a sprinter.
You got to think like a sprinter. You got to think smooth, fast, come out, kill the clock, good form. That's it.
You got two of them to run. You got to run the first one as hard as you can. You don't know what you're saying. Huh?
You don't have to run the second. That's awesome.
What did they give you? So will they give you your time?
I'm not sure.
If you don't know your time, you need to run both of them.